In this video, I'll show you how you get from this snare to this snare by only using one instance of the FabFilter Saturn II plugin. I'm Marlon and this is the White Noise Studio. The reason why I want to show you this is because I find myself grabbing the Saturn II plugin more and more when I want to quickly get a good snare, kick and tom sound. This video will be about the snare drum and the rest of the drum kit will follow in the next videos in this series. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel so you won't miss out on the rest. Okay, let me show you how to get from here to here. First of all, you need of course FabFilter Saturn II. If you don't own it, download the demo. I'll explain my basic approach on mixing snares with Saturn II. You can apply all of this to other plugins as well. And here's the drum part I recorded for this tutorial. I tend to divide the frequency spectrum of the snare in a few parts. It's globally like this. Between 140 and 220 Hz you have the low end thump of the snare. Between 300 and 900 you have the tone of the snare, which is where the resonances and liveliness of the snare lives. From 800 to 2000 Hz you have the skin and the smack of the snare. 2000 to 5500 Hz is the presence, aggressiveness and where the attack starts of the snare, and more of all of that goodness. Around 5500 Hz to 7500 Hz you have the attack of the snare and the snare wire sound, and above that is the air and usually most of the cymbal bleed. This is by no means a fixed set of rules. This is how I approach it, and the mentioned frequencies are guidelines. The exact frequencies will differ from snare to snare, but what I mentioned is in the ballpark. So let's start off with the natural recorded snare drum. It's a Ludwig Supralight recorded with an SM57. No bottom snares, just top snare. Let's open FabFilter Saturn II. I'll start out by adding a band for the attack, the snares, the bus and the clarity of the snare, because that's what's missing here. Now here's one of the reasons why I like Saturn II so much. And that is this little control which applies either gating or compression to the selected frequency band. Let's gate it a little to remove some hi-hat bleed and add saturation to have a bit of a splash on the attack of the snare. Adding saturation will also round off the attack a bit. It limits it while adding harmonics. I also increase the volume of this frequency band like I would use a high shelf EQ. And now I'll go to the low end of the snare. Let's add a band here and check what's happening below. There's some low end rumble and bleed of the bass drum, so let's lower the volume over here. I want to compress the low end thump of the snare and bringing up the volume a bit. I will use the compressor gate dial once again, but set it to compression. Let's tweak the bands a bit. We are now left with this mid-range, which I will divide in two. The lower one has the resonances and the tone. And the upper one has some higher bleed, and this is where the attack starts. So I will gate the upper band a little bit. Make it sound a bit tighter. And I'll compress and saturate this band a bit. I like some resonance in a snare. It makes a snare a bit longer and it helps to cut through in a dense mix. Let me play the snare and the drum recording and do some tweaks. Okay, here's before. And here's after. So with the techniques I used with Saturn 2, you can get a pretty flat sounding SM57 recording to sound thick and kick-ass. You can apply all of this, of course, with EQ, multiband compressors and parallel processing. It only gets a bit more involved. To check out my complete series on using FabFilter Saturn 2 on drums, check my playlist here. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and thank you for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye!